I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Mr. Piller, would you please do the honors?
You bet.
Your heavenly Father, we pray that you watch out for all those who have to be out in the upcoming storms and stuff, that they can travel safely. We pray that you be with our city employees as they deal with the fallout of all the snow that's coming.
We just pray that everything that we do this evening can be pleasing to you. In your name we pray. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Dad. Yeah, the reading and approval of the minutes from March 20th, please.
Motion approved as presented.
Okay, motion by Hack.
Second.
Second by Weidrich. Discussion. All in favor of the meeting, say aye. Meeting minutes, say aye.
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 Opposed? Thank you. All right, approval of the agenda. Any changes?
Okay. Motion to approve the agenda is presented.
Motion by Weidrich.
Second.
And second by Stern. He beat you, Dan.
All right. All right. I got a time delay.
Discussion. All in favor of the agenda, say aye.
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 Opposed? All right. Agenda set. Okay, let's start off with Jared. Engineer's report.
Where would you like me to stand?
Wherever you want.
Wherever you want.
There?
You're good.
Based on the TV here?
Right.
You don't have to.
You're good.
All right, so you should have the agenda in front of you. I'm going to do it just backwards here tonight because the one item with the water project takes a little bit longer. So generally, day-to-day work, Public Works Department, you know, not a lot going on. I'll stick around here at the end. I think Dave had some quote on some manhole rehabs that are not on my agenda. But Expedition Estates. We have met with and been in contact with Williams Building Company. I did get the email from them a couple days ago. They're the ones doing Expedition Estates. Sounds like they are gonna hire us for some construction engineering, which would be staking, some inspection, but they're planning to redo that subdivision. Poor guys, they're planning to do it as early in the spring as they can, but obviously they're held up here. Their whole goal is to have it done sometime in June, because they want to build houses, right? And that's their business, and they want to make money. You can't make money unless you can do construction. So as of right now, everything that I've seen, their plan for reconstruction, their plan to, you know, for what they want to do, passes the smell test. What our role will be is to, you know, guide construction, stake things, witness pressure tests, witness televising, generally be you know, the eyes and ears out there and report to you if there's, you know, they're either passing or not passing. So they are hiring us to do the construction engineering. There isn't going to be any cost to you guys on the whole thing. So if anything changes, we'll let you know. But that is the plan for right now.
Have they signed a contract with the contractor?
I don't know.
I can't say for sure either, but I know they were still
with Sutton, yeah. Visiting. Yeah.
So when we had the meeting with them that day, they made it sound like it was going to be a combination of their guys and the local guy, which is fine. It doesn't matter who does it. It's just, you know, hold everybody to the same level of work. But yeah. Any questions? All right. So I would expect that to happen, you know, sometime as frost comes out and flow restrictions go away. Sanitary sewer stuff, I mean, just I'm repeating on this, I won't take much time, but you have the PAR grant in place to do a bunch of televising. That's pretty much going to wrap up all the televising of the clay pipes you have in town. Your deliverable will be an engineer's report from us, so we'll look at videos or photos of bad spots, and I'll kind of show you guys a summary of what's good, what's bad, you know, what needs to be done, and go from there. So that's slated for the spring. I don't have an update there. There are a couple spot repairs you guys already know about. I would expect that there will be more, so we'll deal with that when it comes, but hopefully not, but there probably will be. And then the water project. So in general, we have three contracts. We have two funding sources. I keep repeating this, but we're essentially done with the project, right? It's energized, it's being used. We're intentionally keeping TAN's contract open to run additional work through them. But you guys recall, we mentioned this before, but we have two change order requests from TAN, and change orders can be any number of things. They can be something that you guys request work to be done. They give you a proposal for work to be done. This falls into the category of they want extra compensation for something. So it's kind of the harder of them. But we've met with TAN about three times in the last 6 months. Initially, we denied their two change order requests, and they met with us. We actually had a meeting with Dan and me and Monty and Dave and the people from TAN to look at these two items and talk about them. You guys probably saw within the stuff we sent on Friday, you got a two-page where we recommend going with this or how we recommend resolving it. Essentially, they're requesting about $50,000 worth of work on two areas. We did not agree with them, and we think that there's some grayness to it, and they probably are warranted some payment for a few of the things. Do you want me to go into the letter, or did you guys all get a chance
to look at
it?
Go ahead.
Okay. All right. I'm just going to keep going then. Generally, item number one on Bluegrass, they're requesting about $11,000 for concrete work that was done. We didn't expect any concrete work to be done. At the end of it, what it comes down to is that some of it, we actually agreed when we met with them, did need to be done because of the proximity of the pipe to the curb. Mm-hmm. Couldn't be saved. So I would say we were wrong to deny that, and we do recommend making that payment. The other portion of it, which they had curb and gutter fall into the trench during construction because they had soil cave in, that I would call carelessness, or they didn't use proper construction techniques to do that, so we would not approve or recommend payment for that. So generally that item is about $11,000, and we do recommend a payment of $6,500 to cover the work that was necessary that we should have had probably in the bid for doing Bluegrass. I will say too, it's hard too because you don't always know where pipes go when you're designing things. So all in all, on the next payment estimate for TAN, I am going to recommend paying them for some additional curb and gutter on that block. So I think they were ready to argue with us. But the other item here is work at the treatment plant, high level. They bid on the project, it's about $1 million job. Their filter based removal portion of the job is about $20,000. We maintained that we didn't do anything wrong, that it's what their bid is their bid. However, when they were removing the concrete filter base, or the filter basins, they were steel. And as soon as they chopped them apart and cut them apart, it turned out there was 2 feet of concrete on the bottom. So their argument was that nobody could have seen that it wasn't known, and that they spent about $35,000 then removing those basins, $35,000 extra dollars removing those basins. And their argument is that they or anybody that would have gotten into construction would have politely requested additional compensation for that work. And I guess I don't know if another contractor would have requested that. We did originally deny it. they do make a strong case, and I could see that they did spend the time doing it, so I don't think their bid was very good, let's say. Their bid was $20,000. According to this, it should have been $60,000 to do this work, because that's what it took them. Tracked their time, you know, logged it, watched them work, so their bid was poor. Their argument, again, is that anybody would be requesting additional payment. And my argument is, well, it's not a problem, but they want to be paid for all of it, right? I mean, their stance is they don't want to meet in the middle, but where I'm at, when I look at it, and I look at the hours they spent and the other contractors' bids, I believe we can justify an additional $15,000, because that does keep them below the next lowest bidder, which would be Wagner Construction.
That's what I was just going to ask you, remember what that was.
Bids were very tight, and I have a ethical problem making a larger payment on this that would have put them, you know, more expensive than the next lowest bidder. So that's where I say it's hard to justify an additional $36,000 of what they're requesting. But as long as you keep it below $15,390, we're not exceeding Wagner Construction's bid. And I feel like there's some wiggle room in the contract there. And as you guys know, we're 60% cost share here from the State Water Commission on this work. So I guess I'm bringing this to you as I think that's a reasonable settlement amount. They're requesting $50,000. Between these two items, we would agree to about $21,000. And I don't think we're stretching anything. I think it's pretty easily justifiable, but it's not paying everything we want. I expect to have some discussion. If you approve it, then I'm basically going to take it back to them and say this is the maximum amount that we can cover on your amount, and then see where they want to go from there. Whether that's, you know, resolving it or meeting again or getting attorneys involved, I'm not certain.
So 60% cost share, our cost then is $12,900, it looks like.
So between the two? Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
60% grant, so 40% cost share.
Yep.
The opposite. Your cost would be about $8,000.
Yeah. What was it, $8,000?
Yeah.
That'd be about $85,000.
It's only $40,000.
I will say, so here's a picture of the cave in. So in that area, we're not paying for the curb and gutter on that block. But when we had to get close to it was a different story, I guess.
Is that on the curb?
No, that's a straight part. There's two driveways right there. Okay. Basically, John made him take that out because it was undermined and we couldn't put it back very well. So made him take it out and pay for it. Or we're not going to pay him for it, I guess.
So then on the other projects, I guess, that they did, you know, like the water tower itself, you know, if their bid was in like $80,000 or whatever. Well, they tore that water tower down in like a day and a half, you know. I don't think that would...
What do you mean?
Well, I mean, I think there's then... Even on that project, it went, I guess, a lot
smoother.
A lot smoother, yeah. You know, versus the other project. So I mean, you know.
Yeah, that's hard. It is. I mean, it's everything we're doing here is, you know, we've got a construction contract for them to do things. And if they bid, you know, all these dollar amounts, and you know, our plans say to do this, they can nitpick and argue, and we generally don't get the money back if something does go smoother. And I can't say if it was smoother or not. I mean, it appeared to be. Everything else did appear to go smooth, Casey, so it's hard to say.
Was it Tanda that took the water tower down?
Yes.
It was.
Well, they have a sub. They have
Dwight.
They hired Dwight to do that demolition part. So I don't know what they paid Dwight to do it. But, yeah. Does anybody have any... I half expected Tan to be here tonight, and they may still be here at the next meeting if they're not satisfied with whatever we come to at this point, because they're tough. They're not going to just... they're probably not going to just accept where we're at, but I feel like it's a fair decision, and wanted to include you guys in it and explain the justification for where our recommendations come from, I guess.
I'm comfortable with Jared's recommendation. I think there's good detail in there that shows that we're communicating with these folks and that we recognize there was some additional stuff that they didn't have a lot of control on. So with that being said, I would make a motion that we approve that the change order payment in the amount of $21,500 to TAN.
We have a motion by Pillar.
Second
by Weidrich. Discussion. Roll call.
Pillar.
Aye.
Weidrich.
Aye.
Hack.
Aye.
Stern.
No.
Obenauer.
Aye.
Okay, so I think the way this is going to play out is that I'm going to go back to them with an approved change order 5 for that dollar amount. So it's going to say their amount that they requested, which is about 50. And it's going to kind of show an offset, and it's going to show approved 21. And then, like I said, we'll go from there. They'll either approve it, or we'll be back here talking about it in 2 weeks. I'm not certain. But I did give them this letter and tipped them off on what I was going to recommend. And, you know, I don't see them here. I'm not certain.
Okay.
All right. Beyond that, though, we are still working with TAN. You know, not the boogeyman. They do good work. We are, you know, you guys approved some change orders of the variety where you requested a short from them at the last meeting. And so they will be here in town. We do have a mud hole in a spot up by Murray's. I want to say on camera that it's got to get addressed. It probably will not be addressed by tomorrow's snowstorm. Unless if you guys say it has to be, I would say use your own crews and we'll have to back charge them or something like that. But as of right now, it's a mud mess, and it'll just have to get through the next storm here. And then we do have a punch list. I know David Monty, when they see stuff or when they get calls or when they get told of things, they relay that to us and that addresses things. The way punch list items work are that are warranty items, right? So TAN's warranty will be running out this fall in about October. So we see things that, you know, aren't the way they should be, or leaking water main or whatever it is, that all gets addressed, you know, at no cost. But I think that's all I have on our report, Monty. Is that right? Okay. Well, I'm gonna stick around through the sewer manhole. Anything else comes up, let me know.
Thanks, Jerry.
Yep.
6-day local permit for bingo for Hazen Chamber of Commerce. And this will be, permit will last the entire year, right, Monty?
It'll end at the end of the year.
Yeah.
Motion to approve.
Motion by Hack. Second by Stern. Discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Thank you. Okay, moving down to 8. Variance consideration. The Fleegers.
Now, as I indicated in my notes, not sure how you wanted to proceed on this. I know we have in the past kind of conditionally approved the variance that all the other conditions are complied with. He is is hoping to purchase the lot up by the school, and turn your head to look at the picture. This is the structure he would like to bring in. It'll be his residence, plus he intends to operate a home-based business out of there. As indicated, in our zoning, permitted uses in this district are single-family dwellings, but it doesn't include mobile homes, which in my mind, this is a mobile home based on the information, the worksheet that he had. So there again, you have the authority as the board to determine if there's a variance to allow that type of structure there or if it has to be something else.
And that's on the lot right beside the basketball court there?
Yes, it is.
Do we know what kind of business?
He's making signs, wooden signs, that he had some for Antoinette's recent event that he had made for as prizes for different things. Just kind of small shellacked, routed signs and engraved signs.
Was he planning on bringing in just that mobile home, or was he planning on outbuilding for his business? Or?
At this point, it was just the mobile home, and he was going to be moving in.
So I'm kind of wondering if that business grows, is he going to want to put up a Holberg shed, or you know what I mean? I don't know.
So you said right now our existing zoning ordinance does not allow for trailer houses in that spot?
No, it does not. It does allow for dwelling modular units, sectional home, but this is basically a trailer frame with a hitch, where those a modular sectional home generally the trailer is, or the frame is removed and it's set on a foundation. And
right. Okay.
Or if you want to get him here and actually explain his intentions in the long term.
I don't know if we really need to have him come in here, but if he, you know, if he wants to express to you some more of his, what's going on, and you bring it to us, Monty. I'm not in a huge favor of bringing in a trailer house into an area that's been, I'm just not in favor of bringing a trailer house into one of those spots. That's just my opinion.
Would he be fixing that trailer house to the lot, or would he just have it sitting there on the trailer? Is he gonna, do you have any ideas? Would he be putting in the concrete pillars and things like that?
Basically, since it looks like it's a pre-owned, it would have to be on pillars. So, yeah, it would basically be a fix then to the lot, more or less.
Okay. Well, you don't hear much in favor, so we don't need to make a motion to deny, we just don't take action. That's kind of what I think I'm hearing, no action being taken right now. We'll move on. 9A, water sewer.
Okay, and the water and sewer, there is an exhibit this evening that was put together by Key to perform the repair, modification, restructuring, if you would, of five additional manholes, bases within the manholes throughout the city. The team has looked for the one that offered the ones that were done, and I see this in part, talked to the boys the other day as we were going through the details on this, and we have some that that I think require or should be taken care of sooner than later. And then a couple of them were probably looking more so as a preventative maintenance to give us long-term performance and better performance with the flow. The company key charges $3,500 for mobile location. So what I'd like to do is see us go after these five that they've given us a quote for. The challenge at hand is that we had some unexpected failures in this calendar year already. So the monies that we had budgeted for this year have been used. But we have some fallback money that is available. For lift stations and manholes and stuff like that. And I see this type of expense already from last year to this year has gone up on a per location rate. So I don't see it getting any cheaper as we move forward. So tonight I'd like to make a motion that we approve the installation of five bottoms and inverts. By key contracting in the amount of $18,500, and then that we would utilize a couple of our category of reserve funds that are subject to this particular type of work.
Okay, we have a motion by Pillar.
Second.
Second by Hack. Discussion. Roll call.
Pillar.
Aye.
Hack.
Aye.
Stern.
Aye.
Weidrich.
Aye.
Obenauer.
Aye. Motion carried. Thanks for putting the time in on that, Dan.
The water boys did all the work on it, but thank you for them.
Anything else, Dan?
I had a conversation this week with Paul Dahl, as everybody's probably aware. He's going through a major overhaul, if you will, of the car wash up at the Senate station. He and I had a lengthy conversation. We're still seeing suspended solids sand coming through. And because we modified that manhole there, the issue at hand has moved from that manhole down the piping down that street. And so we've got some plugins in there. So I had conversations with Paul. He's going back to the manufacturer of the car wash. He said right now the design that they have in there is the design that's used for similar installations everywhere, basically. But he's going to reach out to this provider and have some conversation with regard to possibly putting a filter mechanism, a sock. For just simplify terms, we'll see if that might be able to help us out. And so, with that being said, Jared, you guys could maybe ponder that a little bit and see in your mind if you think that might be a viable option to help us out.
That would be awesome.
That's all I have.
Dan, do you recall, or Dave, have we ever had that line cameraed from that manhole all the way back to the car wash? Is there another spot where all these solids can be coming from? Is there a separation in the pipe or in the line? I don't know. But you know, before 5 years ago, we never had this issue with all these solids in there. I know
part of it was hammered, but I'm not exactly sure. The whole run wasn't, because they actually looked through it, and so they're saying their motorized camera would get stuck in the sand or whatever, so it would need to be completely cleaned to get the camera all the way through. But I don't think we went from the manhole in the street back towards the Cinex building. I don't believe.
I would think that that'd be, you know, just to rule something out, I guess, if nothing else, because we've been talking about this for 3 years, it seems like. That's how many times were over there? Once a month now to flush that thing?
I don't know, eight weeks?
Yeah, that's a lot.
The last time they jetted the manhole down farther, it was actually completely plugged solid.
From just solids, from dirt?
Just sand over there. They had a pretty good picture of it. I don't know if they sent that photograph to Dan or...
Yeah, I got the pictures of it. So, you know, like, we were just speculating in our conversations, but we are seeing a lot more movement of sand in Mercer County here. And when you get the turbulence of the water flowing through there, you think back to your chemistry experiments in high school when you try to suspend solids into a liquid. You know, if you've got a lot of turbulence and stuff, then those solids are going to flow along with. And Paul said that each car wash is using about 60 to 65 gallons of water, not all in one big surge. But it is a fair amount of water, and so the challenge of having that settle out when you have that much water moving, and you've got, on good days, you know, you've probably got six to a dozen cars lined up there that are in succession going. I'm not finding fault in their design, but if some smart heads get together, they can maybe come up with some type of solution that would everybody needs on this.
Well, it's really too bad that they couldn't come up, and it would be more money for Senex, a gutter system with like a septic tank to hold it, and then they hire a Roto-Rooter to come in and clean it. I mean, that's what you see in a lot of these bigger car washes.
Paul said he has somebody coming in and pumping those sumps there. Way more regular than he had in the past. Ever since we started seeing the issues coming at hand, he's increased the times in which they come out there and they do that. So he's not sitting on his laurels by any means. He's supporting the community and trying everything that he can on his side. So that's where I'm hoping, you know, I told him that I was going to ask more to dig into it a little bit, to make another set of eyes on it and see if in another community if they get something similar to that, how they might be able to hear from address the issue.
Thanks, Dan. And it was pretty flat too. It's not, there's not a lot of slope there for movement, which doesn't help either, but
sure.
Yeah. Okay. All right, thanks, Dan. Streets.
About the only thing I got that I talked to Dave with last week is we had that reinforcement done on our plow with the gate. And we also, Dave and I talked about our cylinder issue, which we think we have solved that problem. So what the problem was on the cylinder is, well, the gate, what the reinforcement is, should be good. Dave's going to monitor that, more frequent looks at it. But the cylinder issue is what I was thinking about the most. What was happening was it was traveling past the extension. So if you can imagine a cylinder, it bangs and it slaps. And with our cylinders with the cap with the internal snap ring, it makes sense to me that if it was stroking an extra quarter of a stroke, if that, it's going to eventually blow that seal out or that snap ring. So Dave, what did you say you put in about an extra half
inch? We put an extra half inch of against the bumper when it bottoms out. It was actually not really bottoming out, it was bottoming out the cylinder. So now we added another plate on the bumper. So when it hits that, the cylinder isn't bottomed out, so it should take the pressure off the cylinders. And it seems to be working on it. Yeah.
We'll find out in the next few days.
Yes.
And then Dave and I also talked about the last time we did revamp work on pins and what have you on the other plow was 5, 6, 7 years ago.
Yeah.
We're gonna holes egg out and pins wear out and we're gonna look at that in the off season. I think a little more preventative maintenance would might help our problems maybe. So and then we're all ready for our 4 to 17 inches of snow.
How are you doing on cutting edges?
Good. We should have some left over throughout the summer for next fall.
And I know Jared mentioned having some patch jobs done. I know the Union Bank, Wayne Hoffner called me today because, you know, we had that break right in the driveway. Yeah. They want to make sure that that's part of those patches done. And they might even want to hire whoever does it to do some more of their parking lot.
Yeah, when the break occurred or whatever, yeah, he was talking about having some other additional parking lot.
Yeah, so he just called and said, don't forget about me.
Yeah, I called out measuring the holes today. The snow's getting off of them enough to where I can get some dimensions and stuff so we can get figured out what kind of product we need.
Yeah, I see in Bill Swanson's parking lot. That's that was concrete. Did we cut that out?
On his or the?
No, right in Bill's parking. It looks like about a 7 or 8 foot square that's just mud right now, and I can't remember
if that was on our side or his side of the curb stop. That was when Ryan and Dick were still here.
It's almost touching the street.
Just about touching the street.
So I would say it's probably ours, but I don't know. We'll see.
I can find out on that.
Okay.
Because we'll have to probably do some work on that apron from Old H&R Block building, because the curb stop was in the grass.
Yeah.
But that apron that we changed, we had to cut some of that concrete apron out of there, so we'll have to size that up.
Right. Okay. And then I know it's weird to talk about it with the weather it is, but the tarring, are we getting ready for that? What's that look like? Because the cracks are starting to open up pretty good, and you know, the frost
we're
is
pretty much
up.
Ready once the frost is out and it's you know, snow is gone basically from pretty
we have product.
So we can do, yes.
Awesome.
Yeah, when I informed them how much we would need this year, we should be able to get as much of, well, the whole thing done this year, hopefully.
Yeah, okay, great. So last year we had a hard time getting...
Yep, getting tar. They were short, but yeah, they called, or I talked to them earlier, and they were going to, I told them we'd need around 2,600 gallons or whatever, and they said that would be a problem this year.
Okay. Sorry to belabor the point, but if we have to ridge up Main Street and plow it, we can't haul it out anywhere, can we? Everything's too soft to...
Be too soft to haul it anyways, no.
Too soft.
We had one other spring where we just made the windrow and we just lived with it. Some of it we did haul out and we could dump it on the ditches off
by the shop.
Off the main there and dump it in the ditches and do that.
Okay.
Yeah, because that was the other thing I was going to mention. We argued, we had two, almost 3 days of thawing, and I drove around a little bit after school, and you know, a lot of our areas where it was damming up with water, it's starting to, I mean, even the ditch coming from County 27 into town, it ran quite a bit. So, I mean, I know the dump site over by the school.
Yeah, we won't go in there.
It's holding water.
If we had to, can we take it out to where our recycle pile is out there, where those cars are?
Yeah, that would be hard enough. We could get it out there.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Okay, moving on. Unless you got anything else, Jason.
No, I don't.
Okay. Casey, I think that's the best busing library.
So I don't really have anything this time.
Okay. Police fire?
But all I got is the new police vehicle. They're still working on graphics. The vinyl supposedly just finally got shipped out. I'm going to go talk to Jim about it. Still have no idea when it's going to show up, so I'm going to see if he'll just put the vehicle in service without decals on it. Can I use it as an unmarked patrol vehicle for now? I did visit with Monty earlier today about putting an ad on Facebook asking people to please remove their vehicles from the street if the city has to go out and plow. And I'll visit with Jim about that too, in case we do have to tow some vehicles out of the way. Try to be a little proactive on that, but that's all I got.
And applications for a police officer position?
One so far.
One, we got one. Okay. All right, Buster.
All right, so I'll talk a little bit about the Partners in Planning grant. We did get a preliminary look at some of the materials. Haven't made it through all of the materials as of yet. There's still a piece that needs to get updated. And then that information, we'll sit down and have a conversation with Marty. And then I think after that point in time, we'll be ready for getting it in your hands in terms of how you want to look at it. It's pretty detailed. There's, of course, lots of comments, you know, the narrative is quite lengthy. I'll just say that much. And then the piece that this that the Moore Engineering is doing, that's over 100 pages itself. We've got a couple of the maps, I guess, that need to get updated and whatever. But no, I think it'll be a fine document once we get it. And then what I started to do is went through some of the information and have done a little bit of cutting and pasting from the standpoint. So if I need to go out and talk, which I'm guessing I probably will have to sometime, I could probably highlight a little bit of it rather than, you know, pick out the high points and maybe some of the low points, that type of thing. you know, our time frame on that is really actually May. And May is not very far away. And, you know, the only other thing that I had put a request in for some reimbursement from Department of Commerce and back in December, and we still haven't seen anything from that, which would be about half of the half of the grant that we should. And so I'm kind of, you know, was hoping that we would have those dollars because there, of course, there's another place where we can use those. But be that as it is, I'm sure it'll come in. The other a bit of information that I could share with you is this: we had a I call it a mini MCED meeting, just a meeting of the minds. Beaver and myself and Carrie Cutting and Ian McConnell. They were our grant writers that helped out considerably last year with all of our grants. And after visiting with them, and what we are going to be proposing is that we would keep those folks on probably some kind of a retainer, but not necessarily in the capacity as to where they would do the actual grant writing themselves. It would be more from the standpoint of keeping them on board because of the knowledge that they have that they could offer for projects like that. And so I think that's the direction we're going to move in the future. Mm-hmm. We do have, Beaver was over the other day, and so we did put together a calendar of future MCED meetings, as well as a calendar of future Mercer County Coalition meetings. And that hasn't actually gone out as of yet, but it will go out probably by the end of this week, those dates and times. We do have a MCED meeting coming up next Tuesday. And that's going to be, I think, a pretty important meeting in terms of with some of the discussion that we're going to be having relative to some things in Mercer County.
What time, Buster?
That's a 5 o'clock meeting. We changed the start times on the MCED meetings from 4 to 5, and then the coalition meetings are all set for 5:30 starts. So
you're all welcome to attend any Mercer County Economic Development meeting. You're more than here.
Absolutely.
Actually, we'd like to have you there. So I know it doesn't always fit in the schedules, but instead of reading about it in the paper or just hearing a report from Buster or hearing from me, it's in a short span here. It's, if you get deeper into it, we'd love to have you come to those meetings, but.
You have equalization on April 11th at 5:30.
April 11th, 5:30.
Oh, really? Well, who missed that on their calendar? Okay.
Well, we'll...
But the other thing that I would just add, too, is if you couldn't make the MCED meetings, and you'd like to come to the coalition meetings, mm-hmm. which is that the intent of the coalition meeting is it's a little broader.
Yeah.
It supposedly involves all the mayors get invited, planning and zoning folks, you know, those kinds of things.
County commission.
And the idea is so that mm-hmm. we could keep everybody on the same page in terms of what's happening countywide. Because sometimes there's little pockets of people that don't know really what's going on in the county, you know, and with what's coming down the pipe in terms of future, and certainly what it looks like, people are, I'm sure, going to want to be more aware of what's mm-hmm. what's going to be there and the possibilities and those kinds of things. So, with that, that's all I have.
All right. Thanks, Buster. Monty, did you send Keith Bames' letter out to everybody, his response?
Yes, I believe I did.
Okay, there we get Keith Bames. So we did had a letter of opposition to the bill banning books at the library, and we did send that in, and Keith Bames did get back to us, and he did not support our position, and is going to stay steady and firm on his stance, but if you didn't get to read the letter, take a look at it. It goes into more depth than that. So, all right. 10A. NDERF annual meeting is in Bismarck on May 10th at the Heritage Center. Everybody's welcome to go to that. It's a free meal. And you get to listen to the insurance talk.
Yeah, just let me know and I can RSVP for you if you want.
I've gone before, I've gone numerous times, and it's good discussion. It's just another thing to fit in your schedule. 10B.
That's just one day.
What was that, Dan?
It's about
3 hours is what it is. Yeah. All right, audit representation letter. Monty?
Basically, this is, it's always completed in conjunction with our audit. It's basically stating that we gave them all of the information they requested, that we're following the guidelines to the best of our knowledge, and that we are currently no pending litigation against the city.
Sounds good.
Right. So I will have President Obenauer sign that along with myself and send it back to them.
Thank you. And 10C, request for comments on the highway lighting project. Is that supposed to be a public input, Monty? Or?
Yeah, they will be doing other or additional public meetings on it. They just wanted some responses from us to start with. It was sent to the busing and to the board. Basically, at long and short, if we don't respond, basically it means we're in favor of the project. So, I wasn't sure if you wanted me to just say it, and that we appreciate what they're doing and feel the project is a good thing.
Absolutely.
Or however you would like it.
Yeah. It's a safety thing. Even that's still slated for next summer, 24?
That would be 24, yeah.
Okay. All right.
Unless there's somebody who doesn't like the project.
Nope, I say thumbs up.
Me too. You don't need a motion, do you, Monty?
No, I will just respond that we take no formal position, but we do appreciate the work they're doing. And
thank you. All right, nothing under old business. Under new business, we have one item. We have the graduation book advertising opportunity through the newspaper. I think this, do you have that up there? There it is. Monty and I discussed this the other day, and I don't think there's much of a need for us to take out a full page or even a half page sponsorship, and a lot of the $50 ones are sponsoring individual students. You need to get your name below the student's photo, I believe that's the way. Dan, do you know anything more about that?
I don't know much about it, but I believe so too. Right. I know that there are individualized advertising to names.
Yeah. And I think this is a fantastic opportunity. It doesn't really help us a ton for our visibility and sponsorship, but it does show some support of our students. And you know, I'd be in favor of doing a $50 thing, but not going towards a specific student. It'd be just in general, a sponsorship and support of the graduating class advertising. So I don't know if anybody else had any thoughts when they saw that or not.
Yeah, I like the idea of supporting it, but not tying it to any particular student. So I would make a motion that we go ahead and approve a $50 donation to this cause, but not tie it to any particular student.
Okay. Motion by Pillar.
Second.
Second by Weidrich. Discussion. All in favor say aye.
Yeah.
Oh.
We're spending money.
Oh, we're spending money. It's a roll call. Sorry.
Pillar.
Aye. Aye.
Weidrich.
Aye.
Hack.
Aye.
Stern.
Aye.
Obenauer.
Aye. Motion carried. My daughter will be disappointed we're not going to put our name in your picture. Too bad. Get over it. All right, public comments. Nobody here from the public this evening. Approval of the bills.
Motion to approve the bills as presented.
Yep, motion by Pillar, second by Hack. Discussion. Roll call.
Pillar.
Aye.
Hack.
Aye.
Stern.
Aye.
Weidrich.
Aye.
Obenauer.
Aye. Motion carried. Meeting adjourned. Thank you all.
Thank you.